My name's Ralph Alphonso. I'm the client on this project, and I'm also the producer of this project and project managing it. As the client, I am putting the money up for the project. As the producer, through Barley Store Productions, I am project managing the job. So I'm handling the day-to-day running, I guess, of the project and steering it and driving it. I developed a couple of other townhouses. About 5 years ago I finished, started about 7-8 years ago, and I've also been involved through my photography background, working in the architectural field, and I've been exposed to a lot of construction and building works, and I've had a lot of interest in that, and I've seen the progress towards more sustainable building and also in general lifestyle of sustainability. So when it came to doing something with this portion of land that I had left over, it made sense to try and do something sustainably and draw on my experiences and try and see how far we could actually take it. 5 years ago, when I finished building the townhouses adjacent to the property, I was standing outside with my father, and he said, "What are you doing with this remaining portion of land?" And I think it was a bit of a throwaway comment. He said to me, "Why don't you build another apartment on it?" And I think it was more a sarcastic sort of comment, because it was such a small portion of land and what really could you do with it? And I guess that sort of stuck in my head in the background, and I had an idea to build an additional garage with a roof deck on top of it. And after going through the build process with the townhouses, I thought I'd like to do it in a more sustainable way. And then I guess I kept thinking about how I could do it and what I could do with it, and thought it was a bit of a waste, I guess, building another garage and deck. I looked at all the options, what I could do with that block of land, and one was, I guess, in the background there, building an apartment. And I started looking, I guess, and researching around the world at size of rooms, size of spaces, how you live in that space, and I don't think it's anything new that we're looking at, but I think we're a little bit spoiled here where we spread things out. I started paying attention a lot more to how I use spaces and how I'm using my current space and how inefficiently I'm using it. So I kept researching it, and that's when I started looking at various architects, architectural work from around the world. And it was over about 3 years I sort of narrowed it down before I started engaging with architects and talking about the idea of doing it and putting an idea together, and then going to the architect and saying, "Is this possible? I think it is. Am I being silly, or is this realistic?" I think there are quite a few projects around the world that are this sort of size, if not smaller. There's apartment buildings in New York, Paris, London, Hong Kong that are actually smaller than this, Japan. The things that I could find, case studies and situations like that, I couldn't find anything in a domestic residential situation that has looked at the full analysis of the project, the construction, the occupancy, and then the recycling content of the project. I found various projects that concentrated on various elements of it, but I couldn't find something that looked at the whole project with such scrutiny over every aspect of it. Barley Store Productions is a company I founded a few years back, and it's a production company basically working on boutique projects and creative projects, build projects, multimedia projects, and bringing together the right people to get a result, I guess. So it's project management, So I saw it as a good sort of fit to project manage this job, bring the architects together, the engineers, and so on, and also then use Barley Store and the skills that I've got through that and the contacts to actually produce this job where we could disseminate the information. There was no point going through this whole project and keeping what we learnt from it, whether it was success or failure, to ourselves. So that's where the website and so on is, I guess, the outlet for the information. I think there are going to be quite a few challenges we're going to face in this project. One of them is going to be the economic side of it. So with the client hat on, trying to keep the cost down, trying to work with various companies and partner up with them to work out, I guess, commercial relationships where we could subsidise some of the costs, and as an outlet they can use this project as a vehicle to demonstrate their products in a real life situation. The other one is the usual building challenges, trying to foresee everything that I need and want in the project as a client and translating that to the architect and making sure all that's there at the design stage so that it don't need to be a lot of changes through the project. The best outcome for me as a client would be that it's built on time, it's built within the estimated cost, and it's something livable and something I want to live in and can live in. From the Barley Store side of things, I think it'll be successful if and when people look at this project and can take different aspects away from it, or look at it as a whole project, and also the supporters of the project, the partners in the project team, all basically use this as a vehicle to promote what they can do and the services they can provide in the sustainable field.